यस सर।
ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल एंड वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ ओडिशा स्टेट ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टैटिस्टिक्स, एंड डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टैटिस्टिक्स आर मोस्टली यूज्ड टू डिस्क्राइब द बेसिक फीचर्स ऑफ ए डाटा इन ए पर्टिकुलर स्टडी। ओके, दे प्रोवाइड सिंपल समरीज अबाउट द सैम्पल एंड द मेजर्स। ओके, सो डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टैटिस्टिक्स consists of four major types, such as measures of frequency, measures of central tendency, measures of dispersion or variation, and measures of position. Okay, so for the detailed study, we have our resource person, Mr. K.D. Lenka sir, retired reader, GM University, Sambalpur, and he will be delivering a lecture regarding the descriptive statistics. And before starting of the session, I would like to request all the participants to mute their microphones to avoid unusual disturbance. The participants have any queries or questions regarding the topic, then they may unmute their microphones, or they may also type in the chat box also. And but after the completion of the session, so may I please request Mr. K.D. Lenka sir to start the session. Please, sir.
The rest of the part we have to discuss the that is called the valuable part. The valuable part related to your measures of central tendency, dispersion, variation, and skewness like that. And under measures of central tendency, you may after collecting your data, either from the primary source or your secondary source, the researcher has to process it under a process of processing. The question of editing was there, the question of coding was there, the question of your classification was there, and the question of tabulation was also there. And the presentation of such data, that is information so collected by the researcher or investigator or enumerator, it will be properly presented for the purpose of a comparison. After you are collecting the data and doing all these things, the next part is to this highlight on your measures of central tendency. What do you mean by the measures of central tendency? After the data has been collected and properly tabulated, classified and tabulated, it is very much essential to find out a single value from such data. Large amount of data is up there, it is not possible to study it in detail. We have to make the representatives of such data. You mark in the many students in the in a college, there are around 5 to 6 thousand students. But the vice chancellor or the principal or the authority wants to meet only a few students, and such a few students may be the representatives of the entire 5,000 students. So such representatives may be there are students representatives, maybe president, maybe secretary, like that. Like here in the data, we have to find out the representative, that is the most representative of the data, which is related to measures of central tendency. So now here under measures of central tendency, the main cream, the cream part is the value part, that is called mathematical values, as well as your positional values, that is called the key or your circular point or pivotal point, main point of the measures of central tendency. Under your part of your value of your central values of your data, it is essential to discuss the average part. Average part may be your simple average or may be your weighted average, and such average may be called your arithmetic mean, AM you can say. So you can say that is simple arithmetic mean, or it may be called your quoted arithmetic mean. And the next part of the value, that is called mathematical value, is called your geometric mean. Next one is called your harmonic mean. And the next one is called your weighted geometric mean, combined mean. So many averages are there. And the next one is called your positional average. The positional average related to median, quartiles, deciles, and percentiles, as well as your mode. So these are all your positional average. You know, both mathematical values and the positional values will be discussed one after another. First, we come to the mathematical value, that is called your average. Well, average may be simple average or may be weighted average. Then average, for a calculation of average, we have to divide the entire data into three categories. The first category is called your individual, second category is called discrete, and third category is called your continuous. And discrete and continuous are for grouped data, and individual is called ungrouped data. Well, for the point of view of your ungrouped data, we have to find out the simple average. Well, when ungrouped data are there, how to calculate or how to determine your simple average? Now, the data so given will be represented by symbolically represented by X. Then the X should be, the total data should be added. Then total value will be obtained. And such total value, if divided by the number of items added, will get your simple average. This is the case of your individual observation. Then you come to first one example. Suppose Mr. X, Mr. Ram is there, and Mr. Ram's performance in the examination in five subjects are there. Subject five subject tell us subject number one, maybe mathematics or maybe accounting or maybe any other. Suppose the subject number one, subject number two, three, four, and five. Five subjects are there. Marks secured by Mr. X, that is an individual question, will be, suppose in the first subject he has secured 80 marks, second subject is 70 marks, third subject is 60 marks, fourth subject you 50 marks, and next one is called 90 marks. These are the marks secured by Mr. X in the examination. And these marks will be represented by X. And how many subjects are there? Five subjects are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So N is called your total number of subjects, that is called your 5. And when X means marks will be added, you will get your sigma X, that is the summation of X or a total X. That will be, suppose, 0, 9, 5, 14, 350, suppose. This is the total marks. The total mark, that is sigma X, is equal to 350 and the number of subjects is equal to 5. Then here, your average, that is the arithmetic mean AM, if you say that is called your simple average, which is equal to in individual observation, that is called individual series. In individual series, the value of arithmetic mean or simple average will be obtained by dividing the total marks, that is the sigma X, divided by total number of subjects, that is N. Well, here, total marks secured by Mr. Ram is 350, which is called your sigma X, and number of subjects is called your 5. And 350 divided by 5, that is called 70. The 70 marks will be the simple average of the marks secured by Mr. X. This is the case of individual observation. Whatever you have obtained, it is obtained on the basis of direct information, direct data. But you may follow another two methods, which is called your shortcut method and your step deviation method. And this method is called, this one is called your direct method. But when you will follow your shortcut method, among the marks, any marks will be assumed. Any marks means it. The minimum mark secured by Mr. Ram is 50 and the maximum mark secured by Ram is 90. So 50 to 90, any marks you can take it as your assumption. That is called supposition. So suppose the marks within it. It may be within it. It may be within 50 to 90. Any marks you can take. Suppose you can take 60 marks. Let assume mean 60 marks. Assume mean, or you may say A is equal to 60. Then find out the difference. That means, that is called difference is called your D, deviation. Symbolically you can write D. D is equal to X minus assume mean. X minus assume mean. 80 minus 60, it is 20. 70 minus 60, 10. 60 minus 60, 0. 50 minus 10, minus 10. 90 minus 60 is called plus 3. This is called your D, that is called deviation. And such deviations will be added down. That is called your sigma D, total D. It will be plus 20, 10, 30, minus 10. 20 plus 30. Is equal to 50, plus 50. That is sigma D is equal to 50. And when you are going to calculate your simple average under second method, that is called your stay method, shortcut method, under shortcut method, your actual mean, that is arithmetic mean, or you may say bar X. Symbolically, arithmetic mean is equal to assuming that is A plus sigma D divided by N. That is, A rate you have taken 60 as assume average, you have taken. And sigma D rate total is 50. And divided by N, N is total number of subject, that is 5. So, 60 plus 50 divided by 5, that is 10, is equal to 70. Under a direct method, simple average 70. Under a shortcut method, it is also 70. And in both the cases, the answers remain same. And another method is there, that is called your step deviation method. And the step deviation method can be followed when there is a common factor in the deviations. The deviation 20, 10, 10, 30. This is a common factor is there. The common factor is called your I. I is called your common factor. I is a common factor in deviations. Deviations with the common factors are I. But here common factor is how much? That is 10 here. 10. And the D will be divided by your I. D will be divided by I. That is deviations will be divided by common factor. 20 divided by 10, that is called your 2. 10 divided by common factor 10, 1, 0 divided by 10, 0, minus 10 divided by 10, minus 1, 30 divided by 10, that is your 3. These values are called your D dash. This is called your D dash. So D divided by common factor is called your D dash. So the D dash will be added here now. The D dash, that is sigma D dash, that will be 2 plus 1 L 3 minus 1 L 2 plus 3, that is called your 5. D dash is 5. Now apply a formula for calculation of simple arithmetic mean, that is bar X, that is simple arithmetic mean A is equal to assume mean plus sigma D dash divided by N into I, common factor. So here, assume you have taken in this example 60 plus sigma D dash in this case, that is called your 5. N L R total number of items 5. And common factor I, that is 10. And you solve it. 60 plus how much? 10. That is called 70. Now, under three methods, your direct method, your shortcut method, as well as your step deviation method, third one is step deviation method, the answers remain same, that is called your 70. That is the case of your individual observation. Then come to your second category of data, that is called your descriptive observation. In descriptive observation, that is called your group data also, it is called the number of items, the number of person must Mr. Ram only. so many numbers of RAM are there, maybe 10 or maybe 20, maybe 50 or maybe 100, maybe 1000 like that. Well, you mark the marks, or the marks are in different subjects are there. It is in the case of a discrete series. Discrete series where the marks are there represented by X, and the number of persons securing these marks will be called your frequencies. That is called your A. The marks, suppose 50, 70, 80, 60, suppose 30. These are the marks. The number of persons securing 50 marks, suppose 3. 70 marks, suppose 4. 80 marks, suppose 5. 60 marks, suppose 7. And 30 marks, suppose 1. So these are the persons securing the marks 50, 70, 80, 60, and 30. And their respective frequencies are there. And this is the example of your discrete series. How to find out your simple average in this discrete series? You can apply all the methods, either direct method or shortcut method or your step deviation method. I'm just going through your direct method. Don't follow your shortcut method or step deviation method. You may forget it. The simple one is called your direct method. Well, under direct method, the marks and the frequency will be multiplied. That is called your F into X. That is the F L 3, first case F 3 and 50 into L 150, 4 into 70 into 280, 18 into 5, 400, 7 into 60, 420, 1 into 30, that is 30. FX will be added, that is called your sigma FX. And F will be added, that is called your sigma F. This sigma F in this case will be known as your capital N. And the sigma X, whatever the value is obtained, it will be regarded as your capital N. From 3 plus 4, 7 is a 5. 12 plus 7, 20, 19 plus 1, that is your 20. So sigma F, that is called your N, is called 20. Now add your FX. FX means sigma FX, you say. So like 0, 3 plus 2, 5, 8, 1280. Here, so sigma FX is 1280. Well, under direct method, your simple average, that is AM, that is called your bar X, is equal to, apply the formula, sigma FX divided by sigma F, or you can say sigma FX divided by N, and put the values, sigma FX is equal to 1280 divided by ML 20. Divided, it becomes to 64. So 64 is called your simple average in this case. And this is the case of your discrete part and the under direct method. Shortcut method you can apply, and your step deviation method you can also apply. But follow only one method, that is called your direct method. Then come to another category of group that are called your continuous series. Under continuous series, the classes are there. The classes, suppose it is called 0 to 10, this is the marks, and 10 to 20, 20 to 30, and 30 to 40, and 40 to 50. These are the five classes. The number of students securing these class marks, that is called frequencies. The frequencies will be called your 8, suppose it is called your 3. 10 to 20 marks, suppose 5, 20 to 30 marks, suppose 9, 30 to 40 marks, 2, and 40 to 50, suppose 1. So these are the information given, and on the basis of that information, we can apply either direct method, or you can apply your shortcut method, or you can apply your step deviation method in order to determine the value of your simple average. তাহলে আন্ডার দিস ক্লাস হাউ টু ডিটারমাইন ইয়ার সিম্পল অ্যাভারেজ তাহলে ইচ ক্লাস র মিডল ভ্যালু উইল বি টেকেন ইনটু অ্যাকাউন্ট ফার্স্ট মিডল ভ্যালু হাউ মিডল ভ্যালু উইল বি টেকেন না ইন ইচ ক্লাস দেয়ার আর টু পার্ট এক্সট্রিম পার্ট ওয়ান ইজ লোয়ার পার্ট অ্যানাদার ইজ আপার পার্ট The lower part plus and the upper part will be added and divided by 2. You will get the middle value. That is called your suppose m. M is called your middle value. M is called your middle value. Middle value is equal to lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. Your lower limit is 0. Upper limit is 10. 0 plus 10. Like 10 divided by 2. That is 5. Then middle value first group of 5. Second group. 10 plus 20, 30 divided by 2, 15. And third group, 20 plus 30, 50 divided by 2, 25. 30 plus 40, plus 70 divided by 2, 35. And 40 plus 50 divided by 2, that is called your 45. These are called your M. And under your direct method, such F and M will be multiplied. And F and M will be multiplied, that is FM. F3, 5 your middle value 3 into 5, 15, 5 into 15, 75, 9 into 25, 225, 2 into 35, 70, 1 into 45, 45. You add the FAM and add your F. F is equal to sigma F. That is called your N. That is 3 plus 5, 8 plus 9, 17 plus 2, 19 plus 1, 20. Sigma F is equal to 20. Sigma FM, F into middle value. That is 5, 5, 15, 5, 5, 10, 5, 8, 5, 20, 2, 2, 6, 13, 15, 5, 6. 430 suppose here. So sigma FM is equal to 430, F is equal to 20. Now apply a formula under direct method, that is your M, that is simple arithmetic mean, that is AM is equal to sigma FM divided by sigma FM N, that is 430 divided by 20. And it comes to 21.5. So this is called your simple arithmetic mean under a direct method in group data or in continuous observation. We apply the direct method. Well, in this year, we can finish up your calculation of simple arithmetic mean. And the next one is called your weighted arithmetic mean. Well, how to find out your weighted arithmetic mean? Suppose the marks are there, marks in 5 subjects are there. First subject 50, then 60, then 70, then 80, then 90. These are the marks, that is called your X. And weightage are there. Weightage means each subject will not be taken only equal weightage. All the subjects will not carry equal weightage. So many subjects are there. Such subjects are very important for us and they will be weighted more. Well, in this case, suppose the weightage are there in first subject weighted 1, weighted means W you can say, second subject weighted 2, 70 subject weighted 4, 80 subject weighted 5, and 90 weighted suppose you are 7. So these are the weights given. So under such weights, how to find out your weighted average? So your weighted average will be obtained, weighted average. That is called your bar x w. Bar x means arithmetic mean, simple arithmetic mean, w and weights. How it will be obtained? The x will be multiplied with the w. Tale w into x. That is 50 into 1, that is 50. 60 into 2, 120. 70 into 4, 280. And 80 into 5, 400. 90 into 7, 630. You add the WX, that is called your sigma WX. It will be 1480. And your weighted average WX is equal to sigma wx divided by sigma f. Tali sigma f here w. Tali w here, total w is sigma w is 7 plus 5 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. 19. Then wx ella 1480 and sigma w ella 19. And you divide such two and you will get your average, that is called your what? The weighted average. And the next one is the question of your what? Now combined average. Combined average. Combined average, suppose three persons are there. Mr. Ram, Mr. Hari, Mr. Gopal. Three persons are there and the number of marks secured by them, and the marks secured by Ram, suppose 60, Hari 70, Gopal 80. And these are the marks, and the number of Rams, means Ramhale Loko Achanti, that is called your N1, number of first one N1. And this is called your X1. And second, Mr. Hari Malia Lokasandi, N2. And Yala X2. And Gopal Malia Lokarayle, N3. And this is called X3. And how to find out the average marks of such three groups? Under such three groups, you have to find your combined mean, that is called your combined average. That is called your combined average, which is called to n into x1. X1 is mean, that is called your arithmetic mean. That is called your individual mean. That is called your bar x1. And the second is plus n2 into bar x2. That is bar x2 for it. And the Gopal group is plus n3 into Gopal group means bar x3. Whole divided by N1 plus N2 plus N3, and it becomes your mark. N1 means here, N1 suppose you do it, N2 suppose 5 that, N3 suppose 3 that. So you put the information in this setting. N1 jagar you can write 2 into bar X1 jagar 60. Plus N2 jagare 5 into bar X2 jagare 70 plus N3 jagare 3 into 80 divided by N1, that is your 2, N2 that is 5 plus N3 that is 3, and solve it. 2 into 60 120 plus 5 into 70 350 plus 3 into 80, 240 divided by 2 into 5 plus 3. That is 10. And it comes to Jahala total divided by 10, you will get your combined average. This is the trademark question. You manage to find it out. And the process is very simple. In the case of your simple average, you will get your weighted average and the combined average. In the case of individual observation, discrete observation, as well as your what? The continuous observation. And the next one is called your geometric mean. Another mean is there. Geometric mean GM. Then GM is meaning the nth root of the product of n number of items. N number of items. Suppose the items are x1, x2, x3, like up to xn pajanta. And these number of items will be multiplied. And find out the nth root. Nth root means nth root over of x1 into x2 into x3 up to xn pajanta. The result so obtained is called your geometric mean. And such a geometric mean is particularly applicable in the case of calculation of population growth, as well as the calculation of your compound interest like that. And geometric mean another way for calculating geometric mean will be there. Suppose geometric mean for calculation of 2 and 3 and 4. These are the single items. How to calculate your geometric mean of 2, 3, 4? 2 multiply 3 multiply 4. How many items? 1, 2, 3 items. And find out to third root over, cube root over. And you will get it. And this get is called your geometric mean part. And the less case call your geometric calculation, you can take the help of your logarithm. And you mark the marks obtained by Mr. H in the 50, 60, 70, like that. And these, how to find out the geometric mean of 50, 60, and 70? And you take the help of a logarithm, that is log x. The log of 50 ra value bahar kara. Log of 60 ra value bahar la. Log of 70 ra value bahar la. Eta ko total kar diya. That is called your sigma log x. Ek tiritan ka log of total kar dele bahar kara. This is sigma log x. And the number of items, that is called your m, 1, 2, 3. 3. And in this case, your geometric mean will be anti-logarithm. Anti-log, that is called your AL of sigma log x divided by n. Well, in this case, that is called anti-logarithm AL log x of value item divided by number of items 3. Echo anti-logarithm value divided by 3. Tara anti-logarithm value is called your geometric mean. You know, you can take the help of a logarithm or you can take the help of your product for the purpose of calculation of geometric mean. It will be calculated both for your group data as well as your whole group data and maybe individual observation, maybe your descriptive observation in continuous observation. But in continuous observation, you can take the middle values of the classes. That will be called your M. Then you can follow your method of your calculation of geometric mean. And the next one is called your harmonic mean. Generally, in the case of your calculation of harmonic mean, the harmonic mean generally in the case of your speed undertaken by your vehicle from to a particular, to cover a particular distance with the uniform speed, uniform with the acceleration and velocity. In this case, we have to find out the harmonic mean. Take the case of your average here is your harmonic mean, not your geometric mean, not your what, the simple average or weighted average. You can take the help of your harmonic mean. The harmonic mean, that is called your HM. That is the harmonic mean. Harmonic mean, that is in case of individual observation will be there, discrete observation will be there, in the continuous observation will be there. In the case of your, suppose individual, individual harmonic HM is equal to how much? N divided by sigma 1 by x. N means number of items. X means the given information. Suppose the given information is 30, 40, and 50. Well, in this case, the reciprocal, that is called x, 1 by x. Then 1 by x means 1 by 30, 1 by 40, 1 by 50. That is 1 by x. And you add it. That is sigma 1 by x. Total jatikella. Number of item 1, 2, 3. Then n ella 3. Then n 3 divided by sigma 1 by x ja bahala divided by the indicate your harmonic mean. In the case of your individual observation. But in case of your discrete observation, harmonic mean is equal to sigma f, that is capital N divided by sigma f by x. Suppose your x is 30, 40, and 50, and your frequency is 2, 4, and 5. Well, in this case, you have to find out the f by x. F by x, that is 2 by 30, 4 by 40, 5 by 50. And add your f, that is sigma f, add your f by x. F by x jamilla, f total hala, a formula put kardale, you will get your answer. That is the value of your harmonic mean in case of discrete observation. Well, similarly, in case of your continuous observation, you convert the class into your discrete observation by taking the middle values of the class, and that is called your M. Now M is there, F is there. Naturally, your harmonic mean will be sigma F divided by sigma M F by M. F by M. Sigma F by M. Then you have M as a middle value in continuous observation, F as a frequency. If you put the values here, and you will get your answer. And this is the case of your harmonic mean in case of a continuous observation. Then what will be the relation among such a three? Then HM, GM, and AM. Then the relationship among such a three observation will be in a case of a normal distribution, you are AM, arithmetic mean is greater than geometric mean is greater than harmonic mean. You can take the help of any example. Suppose you can take the case of your example. Suppose you are going to be asked in the examination, prove that AM is greater than GM is greater than HM. That means arithmetic mean is greater than geometric mean is greater than harmonic mean. You can take any example, numerical example. Suppose the examples are there like that. Two, four, eight. Three items are there. And so the three items are, you can find out arithmetic mean. AM is equal to 2 plus 4 plus 8 divided by 3, number of items. Archery bar, the chowder divided by 3. Into bar. Like that. And harmonic mean, geometric mean is right here. Geometric mean is equal to 2 into 4 into 8, 3 items. Q root. That is called your. Q root. That is called your 4. And the next one is called your harmonic mean. HM is equal to N, that is 3 divided by sigma 1 by x. That is called 3 divided by sigma 1 by x means 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8. That is 3 divided by sigma jahala. Tar value ta bahar pala. 3 point something as. Tale ei kire compare kara gala dekha gala je arithmetic mean 4 point something ye hala 4 ye hala 3 point something. So arithmetic mean is greater than harmonic mean is greater than arithmetic mean is greater than geometric mean is greater than harmonic mean. You can take the help of the numerical part at your own and prove it. And this is the case of your relation among arithmetic mean, harmonic mean, and your geometric mean. And the next part of your measures of central tendency is related to your the median. That is called your positional concept, median. And in the case of individual observation, you can take individual observation. Median means the middle values. Well, in this case, before taking the middle values, first of all, the data will be arranged in either ascending order or in descending order. Ascending order, Sanur border kramar ascending order, descending order. Border samakram is descending order. Ascending order or descending order, first you arrange the data, given data for the individual observation. Let's find out the number of items. That is called your N. That is called number of items. Well, number of items, let's see whether the number of items will be odd one. Odd one means it not divisible by 2. It may be 5, may be 7, may be 9, may be 11, may be 30 like that. These are odd numbers. When divisible by 2, this is called your even number. Suppose the number of items may be your odd number or may be your even number. But if the number of items will be odd number, the median, that is M, M equal, you can say the median, median will be value of n plus 1 divided by 2 items. Suppose a 5th item is 5th number of items n is 5 plus 1 is 6 divided by 2 is 6 divided by 2 that is 3rd. Hello, ascending order is descending order. जे 3 नंबर रे अछि से 3 नंबर वैल्यू टा को कोआ जाए हमरा मीडियन एंड नॉट द थर्ड नॉट द 3 द n plus 1 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 आइटम्स अनदर पार्ट इज इफ द नंबर ऑफ आइटम्स इज अ इवन नंबर इन केस ऑफ अ इवन नंबर द मीडियन इज नॉट n plus 1 बाय 2 एंड द मीडियन इज इक्वल टू एवरेज वैल्यू ऑफ average value of n by 2 item and n by 2 plus 1 item. ये अंतर average value का तमाने n by 2 item जगह जी रहेगा सही value का and n by 2 से इतना आउ उटे अधिक नहीं करले सही value दिखा मिसे नहीं तब दो ही हम दले average value बारी पड़ी तो in this case suppose the number of items है लाख 100 टा तो ये even number तो एक केस रहा अमर मीडियन का कहता है वो द 6 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 आइटम दैट इज थर्ड आइटम रे जी आछी तक्तार वैल्यू टा को नहीं गले तापर आउ को वैल्यू टा नदी ना n बाय 2 प्लस 1 त माने 6 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 होला थर्ड प्लस 1 होला एक होला सारी 4 नंबर आइटम त का अर्थ का होला 3 नंबर आइटम 4 नंबर आइटम मिसे देली डिवाइडेड बाय 2 3 4 7 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 इज इक्वल टू 3.5 दैट इज नॉट तीनि नंबर जगह रे जो वैल्यू टा अछि राम हरि गोपाल जे अछि तार वैल्यू प्लस 4 नंबर जगह रे जो वैल्यू तार वैल्यू मिसे देखि डिवाइडेड बाय सपोज वर आइटम देली माने कर 30 10 20 40 ए सपोज देला 4 आइटम्स ए 4 आइटम्स हला ओ इवन नंबर त इवन नंबर करे हमे कोन करिवे देखिला ताको सजाडीबा प्रथमे असेंडिंग ऑर्डर रे सजाली असेंडिंग असेंडिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ मैग्नीट्यूड सगाली फास्ट रे सानो डाला 10 ताटू बडेला 20 तापर हला 30 तापर हला 40 एटा सजाडी जाली प्रथम तापर देखली नंबर ऑफ आइटम्स केते गोटे जोडे 3टा 4टा 4टा अछि तापर एटा हला गोटे इवन नंबर हे गेला ई बीडी जी इवन नंबर ताले हमर मीडियन वैल्यू टा केताब ना मीडियन वैल्यू टा हबो n बाय 2 आइटम एंड n by 2 plus 1 item or average value mane divided by 2 that is n by 2 mane 4th by 2 item another kala 4th by 2 plus 1 item whole divided by 2 tell in this case four by 2 mane second item and your 4 by 2 plus 1 hala third item तले काउंट ही सेकंड आइटम रे क्लियर होला फर्स्ट सेकंड रहला 20 दिस इज सेकंड आइटम त सेकंड आइटम रो वैल्यू टा 20 प्लस थर्ड आइटम वैल्यू होला के एटा सेकंड एटा थर्ड आइटम वैल्यू होला 30 तो 20 प्लस 30 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 इट इज कॉल्ड योर 50 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 इट इज कॉल्ड योर 25 तो 25 इज कॉल्ड योर मीडियन एंड मीडियन वैल्यू जो है यार इन केस ऑफ इंडिविजुअल ऑब्जर्वेशन and the rest observation is called your what discrete observation and under discrete series we have to find out your x will be there frequency will be there x of your 10 20 30 and your 40 and frequency la 14 16 17 13 These are all your frequency. So in this case, your discrete observation, how to find out your median. In the case of a discrete observation, first your frequency will be cumulative. That is called your cumulative frequency. That is called cumulative frequency. First, that is CFA, you can say. That is cumulative frequency. First one is say 14. 14 plus 16. That is called your 30 and 30 plus 17 that is called 47 47 plus 13 that is called your 60 so here total number of frequencies that is called a sigma f that is called your capital N is equal to total, that is 60. Well, in this case, how the median will be obtained in discrete observation? The median will be value of N plus 1 by 2 item. N plus 1 by 2 item. N here, total number of frequency, that is 60. Divided 60 plus 1 divided by 2. That is 61 by 2. That is 30.5 item. Such 30.5 item or value is median. Well, 30.5 the quote in cumulative frequency 40 that is 47 vitare ni achi. So 47 vitare tar x value ta hala 30. So you mark the 30.5 item in 47 vitare achi. Yara x value ta, that is 30, is equal to median in this case of your discrete observation. And another observation is called your continuous observation. In the continuous observation, very important, you may be asking the question in the examination, continuous observation. In continuous observation, you can say certain classes or marks are there, 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to suppose 40. And the number of students, that is the frequency they are there. Suppose 0, 3, 7, 10, 10. These are the frequencies. Well, in this case, you have to find out your what? The cumulative frequencies, CF. So, the CF is the first one, 3, 3 plus 7, 10, 10 plus 10, 20, 20 plus 10, 30. And here your N is equal to 30. Your N is equal to 30. Well, in this continuous observation, your median will be value of N by 2 item. Median will say middle value. Middle value, entire N is divided by 2. You will get your middle value. Well, when the N will be divided by 4, चारी थरो ता चारी भाग करिवा प्रत्येक भाग टा गुटे गुटे क्वार्टर कहा जीव तनो फर्स्ट क्वार्टर सेकंड क्वार्टर थर्ड क्वार्टर फोर्थ क्वार्टर तनो फर्स्ट क्वार्टर हला क्वार्टाइल 1 सेकंड क्वार्टर ता होची मीडियन यू कैन से थर्ड ता होची हाईएस्ट क्वार्टाइल दैट इज Q3 एंड लास्ट क्वार्टाइल इज हला Q4 यदि एंड ऑफ चारी भाग करा जाए एंड एंड ऑफ यदि 10 भाग करा जाए यू मे से इट इज अ डिसाइल एंड फर्स्ट डिसाइल सेकंड डिसाइल थर्ड डिसाइल अप टू 10th डिसाइल and jaddi n ta ame 100 bhag kariba you will get your what the percentile 1 2 3 up to 100 percent then the median quartile decile percentile these are all there but in case of calculation of median you have to find out in case of continuous observation that means the n will be divided by 2 then the entire n will be divided by 2 equal halves will get your median value. Then when n is divided by 2, n is a total item, that is 30. 30 divided by 2, that is called your 15 item. Then you mark 15 item, that count is achi dekhiba. 3 cumulative bhitare nahi. 10 re nahi. 20 your 15 item achi. 10 paratho, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, up to 20 pajanta, 20 pajanta, आमर 15 आइटम ता रहितो तो 15 आइटम ता रहला ता एटा एटा असला आमर एटी 15 आइटम रह जितो नो एई 15 आइटम आमर ग्रुप ता होची 20 रु 30 लाइज इन क्लास और ग्रुप 20 टू 30 दैट मींस योर मीडियन निश्चित रूपे 20 ऊपर उठिबो 30 भीतर रहइबो तने आमे बाहर करिवा हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द एग्जैक्ट फिगर of your median which is above 20 and below 30. So in this case, you have to find out a formula. That is, the formula is there. Formula for calculation of median in case of your what? The continuous observation. That is, the median is equal to right here, formula L1 plus N by 2 minus C divided by frequency into L2 minus L1. This is the formula. So in this case of your L1 means the lower limit of the median group. So median group ta ame select kale 20 to 30. Here lower limit ta hochi 20, upper limit hala 30. Lower limit hala L1, upper limit hala L2. So you can write in place of L1, write your 20. Plus n by 2. N by 2 item you have, you see 30 by 2. N hala 30 divided by 2. Minus a C. Tale you identify the C. C is very important. Tale median group immediate preceding or pachata of the cumulative frequency is called a C. C indicates the cumulative frequency preceding to your median group. This is your median group cumulative frequency la 20. Here a pachata. Pachata means pachata kya achi cumulative frequency 10. Eta ko ame C kahiba. Ei 10 ta ko ame C kahiba. तो मीडियन ग्रुप जति था त 10 टू 20 तार पछर के छि 3 एटा गंदी मीडियन माने सी सपोज द लास्ट ग्रुप का दी मीडियन था त तार सी हे तंदा 20 तले सी रो आइडेंटिफिकेशन इज वेरी इंपोर्टेंट क्यूमुलेटिव फ्रीक्वेंसी प्रीसीडिंग टू मीडियन ग्रुप एटाला मीडियन ग्रुप हियर पूर्व क्यूमुलेटिव फ्रीक्वेंसी ए केस रे 10 तनो काई इन केस ऑफ इन प्लेस ऑफ सी राइट 10 डिवाइडेड बाय फ्रीक्वेंसी frequency of that median group. Median group of frequency is eta, eta. That is F eta. Eta F. Eta C. Eta F. Frequency of the median group. That is 10. Into L2 minus L1. L2 is 30 minus L1 is 20. You solve it. Jahala, eta is median value. 30 by 20 is 15 minus 10 divided by 10. Into 30 to 10 hella 10. That is called your 20 plus 50 to 10 hella 5 divided by 10 into 10. 10 hella 20 plus 5 is equal to 25. Your median is 25. 20 to 30, that is called your 25. And in the case of this is called all regarding your median. Next one is called your quartiles. The quartiles here are very important. Quartiles here, that is called your quartiles. Quartiles. Median of next part of the quartile, then a decile, then a percentile. It is there in the your books, that is called your quartiles group, that is called your entire n is divided by Sari Bhaga Kordali Hala quartile. Dibhaga Kole median, Dosaba Kole decile, Sahibhaga Kole percentile. The n divided by 4. Prathama Bhagata Hala Kete quartile number 1. सेकेंड हला क्वार्टाइल नंबर 2 थर्ड आसीला भागटा हला क्वार्टाइल नंबर 3 आ लास्ट भागटा हला क्वार्टाइल नंबर 2 एही दीटा क्वार्टाइल वेरी इंपोर्टेंट क्वार्टाइला क्वार्टाइल 1 आ ओटाला क्वार्टाइल 3 क्वार्टाइल 2 दला मीडियन इट्स द लास्ट क्वार्टाइल और योर अलजेब्रिक ट्रीटमेंट और अलजेब्रिक ऑब्जर्वेशन क्वार्टाइल नंबर 1 एंड 3 बोथ आर इंपोर्टेंट देयर कॉल्ड एस्टीम क्वार्टाइल दैट इज क्वार्टाइल 3 एंड क्वार्टाइल 1 तले क्वार्टाइल 1 एंड क्वार्टाइल 3 कैलकुलेशन इज सेम इन केस ऑफ योर मीडियन लाइन तनो मीडियन इन द 2 डिवाइडेड इतले एंटा इट इज केवल एंटा फर्स्ट क्वार्टाइल पै माने 4 डिवाइड हैला n बाय 4 इज 1 अ थर्ड क्वार्टाइल पै हैव 3n बाय 4 दिस इज द डिफरेंस ओनली बाकी ऑल कैलकुलेशन प्रोसीजर ता मीडियन भलिया माने हबो तनो फर्स्ट क्वार्टाइल जे फार्मूला अप्लाई करबो एते आसीबो n by 4 minus c by f into l2 minus l1 that is third quartile bar kariba bar achi 3n by 4 minus c third quartile tala 3n by 4 first quartile tala n by 4 eti ka sila difference baki calculation ta like your median eta la quartile decile ra nahi amro importance mane research purpose pai percentile bhi nahi to sele pai mu kahuna and next one is call your mode asila another positional values tell in this case in the case of your observation when mode is to be determined we have to find out the item having a highest frequencies jo ta ko beshi pasand karsun je ame seita ko bahar karibar ache tell mode ta in the case of individual will be there here a quantum and a discrete will be there. But you are going to discuss the mode of of your continuous observation. Suppose the continuous observation, that is called your class or a marks are there, and the marks will be there, that is 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, and your 40 to 50, that is 5 classes are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the groups of your frequencies are there, AF will be there. AF will support 2, 3, 12, 7, and 8. These are the frequencies. So in the case of a calculation of a mode, mode means the items of hearing the highest frequencies. And first, find out which one is the highest frequency among the given frequencies. 2, 3, 12, 7, 8. Here is the highest frequency, 12. This is your highest frequency. This is called your highest frequency. Your mode is the items, means the class bearing the highest frequency. The class that is 20 to 30 is the modal class. That is called a modal group. And this group is mode of chital. Mode is 20 to 30 with the variable. Then here, highest frequency is 12. And next is how to determine the your mode. So in the case of your mode calculation, you can apply a formula that is called interpolation formula. Formula for calculation of mode. Formula for calculation of your mode is mode is equal to L1 plus F1 minus F0 divided by 2F1 minus F0 minus F2 into L2 minus L1. In this case, L1 means the modal group lower limit. The modal group is value 20 to 30. Lower limit is 20. Then L1 is 20. And L2 has higher upper limit of that modal group, that is 30. And F1 means the highest modal frequency, that is called here 12. F1 is 12. Tar preceding, tar purbata, that is F0. Tar porota, that is F2. Tal here, F1 is 12, F0 is 3, F2 is 7. And apply or put such information in the given formula. And instead of L1, you can write here 20 plus F1, that is 12, minus F0, that is 3. Divided by 2 into F1, 2 into 12, minus F0, that is 3, minus F2, that is 7, into L2 minus L1, 30, minus 20. Aku solve kardele, you will get your mode. Tale, these are called your calculation of mode in case of continuous series. It is very much essential to identify which one is F1, which one is F0, and which one is F2. And remember the interpolation of interpolated formula and put such information as you get your answer. This is called regarding mode. Another part is when the mode is ill-defined. Mode is ill-defined in the sense, suppose in the case of a bimodal group. Bimodal means the D-janka frequency, manakara, D-janka tie-hegala frequency. I'm a good type of mode. Kariwa. Say, case, taku outke rigorous test kariwa, taku table method and grouping table re. Analysis kari modal group ta first choice mane select kariba ta pare apply kariya formula answer aibe jodi still dene bhi tie he gala tale sei case re tie case re ame kon kariba ode empirical relationship neba mean median and mode bhitare tale empirical relation mean median and mode ye bhitare value bahar kare pai kon kon relation ache tin bhitare तो मोड का डिटरमिन करा जीवा जते वाला मोड इज इल डिफाइंड ता माने मोड का फर्स्ट रे डिटरमिन दे ही पल्ले ने सेकंड रे ग्रुपिंग रे भी डिटरमिन दे ही पल्ले ने थर्ड रे हमें ए मीन और मीडियन साज नबा तले मीन मीडियन मोड का रिलेशनशिप ता हम देखिबा जे मीन मीडियन मोड का रिलेशनशिप ता को का का भीतर की टाइप रे रिलेशनशिप अछि मोड ता हाउ टू डिटरमिन योर मोड इन केस ऑफ mode is not defined properly. That is ill defined. ತಲೆ ಏಕೆಸರೆ ಮೋಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ರಿಲೇಶನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಏನವೆ ಮೋಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 3 ಮೀಡಿಯನ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 2 ಮೀನ್ ತಲೆ ಇನ್ಫರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ರ ಮೋಡ್ ಟ ಬಾಹರ್ ಕರಿಯಾ ಪೈ ಆಗ ಮೀಡಿಯನ್ ಬಾಹರ್ ಕರಿಬಾ ತಾ 3 ಗುಣನ ಕರಿ ದವ ಮೀನ್ ಮೀನ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಅರಿಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ ಮೀನ್ ಬಾಹರ್ ಕರಿಬಾ ತರ 2 ಗುಣನ ಕರಿ ದಿಟಾ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ನೇ ಬಂದ ಮೋಡ್ ತರ ಇದೆ ತಲೆ ಮೋಡ್ ಟ ತಲೆ ಇಲ್ ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಐತಿ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದಿ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಚ್ ರಿಲೇಶನ್ಶಿಪ್ of the mean, median, and mode. So then next you can refer to your what the second testing, second observation that is called your what measures of variance. Measures of variance. Measures of variance. Well, relating to measures of variance, first measures of variance is called your range. The range means the highest value and the lowest value or distance is your difference is called your range. So range is called the highest value minus or lowest value. Highest value minus or lowest value. Jekonsi data achi data ro lowest ko nigalo highest nigalo highest to lowest minus ko dali negate your range. तापर नेक्स्ट कॉल ईयर व्हाट दी कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ रेंज कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ रेंज इज कॉल्ड द हाईएस्ट माइनस और लोएस्ट डिवाइडेड बाय हाईएस्ट प्लस लोएस्ट एट असली यू कैन गेट ईयर व्हाट रेंज नेक्स्ट वन इज कॉल्ड योर क्वार्टाइल डेविएशन quartile deviation that is called semi interquartile range should have gone the so quartile deviation is equal to q3 minus of q1 divided by 2 it all highest quartile q3 it all second first quartile these are difference the do divide by the get here what quartile deviation or you can say is equal to qt and the next one is here coefficient of a quartile deviation coefficient of quartile deviation qd means quartile deviation that is q3 minus q1 divided by q3 plus q1 dekho si observation there q3 bahar kali q1 bahar kali formula re put kar dele you will get here what the quartile coefficient of quartile deviation next one is called here what the case of your mean deviation these are all variances range quartile deviation and their respective coefficients and next is the mean deviation md mean deviations that is called your md then in the case of a mean deviation come md that is called mean deviation may be calculated from mean then mean deviation is called your sigma mod x minus x bar divided by mod x divided by x bar divided by n tale eti x bar ortho ta hauchi mean of the observation do doctor diya jai chi may be single data or may be your what discrete or may be continuous pratham mean ki ma arithmetic mean bar karibi एक्स रो आइटम जोटा दिया जाय छी सेतरो मीन ता माइनस कर देबे प्लस माइनस और ताको इग्नोर करबे काहेकि यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द डिफरेंस ओनली नॉट द प्लस और माइनस तन प्लस माइनस इग्नोर ताको मॉड कुला जाय तन दीटा माने पोल भीतर रख रख दे छी मॉड माने प्लस माइनस इग्नोर तार टोटल कर दे डिवाइडेड बाय एन हला मीन डेविएशन अन अनदर केस इन केस ऑफ कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ मीन डेविएशन coefficient of mean deviation md tale coefficient of mean deviation that is called your md divided by mean deviation jar aagla divided by bar x jadi tum mean bar kala then median bar kala divided by median and jemiti jar karan this is called your mean deviation next one is called your what the standard deviation standard deviation standard deviation standard deviation, or in this your standard deviation symbol, you can say SD. Then standard deviation in case from the either you can apply your what the shortcut method, or you may apply your what the direct method, or your what the step deviation method. Sequence method you can apply for the purpose of a calculation of your what the standard deviation. Then standard deviation from actual mean, when actual mean is called your round figure, integer round figure. Then you can apply the formula like that. Actually, mean is a round figure. See, your standard deviation that is called SD. SD is equal to sigma x minus x bar r whole square divided by m r either whole or root over. That is called your sigma standard deviation. That is called your small x r whole square divided by m r root over. Here स्मॉल एक्स अर्थटे होची एक्स माइनस एक्स बार इज इक्वल टू स्मॉल एक्स स्मॉल एक्स तनो स्मॉल एक्स होल स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाय एन बट इन केस ऑफ योर ग्रुप डाटा दिस कॉल्ड इंडिविजुअल डाटा इन केस ऑफ अ ग्रुप डाटा फ्रीक्वेंसीज आर देयर तनो स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन दैट इज रूट ओवर ऑफ योर sigma a into x minus x bar ro whole square divided by sigma f, or you can say x minus x bar is the small x dharili f into small x ro whole square divided by sigma f. Sigma f tak madhya ame n nahi pariba sigma fx square divided by sigma f. Ei paribhavare you can apply the formula and get your answer. But sometimes you can take the help of your what assume mean method. You can take the help of your step deviation method for calculation of standard deviation. And those methods follow the answers remain same. And the next one is called your what the case of your variance. Variance of the type is standard deviation squared. जितनी की standard deviation वाला का square नहीं गला हमें variance से पाइए. The variance is the standard deviation of square, and another part is like coefficient of standard deviation. That is your, I mean, standard deviation is the mean divided by the length. I mean, the coefficient will be obtained. The coefficient of standard deviation is the ratio of your standard deviation and your mean of that data. And the next one is called your measures of skewness. Skewness. Measures of skewness. And in the case of your measures of skewness, we mark skew orthogon. I mean, जाने से जब कौन सी information data दिया जाए ची, हमें ताको normal धरी परिवार, जब दी normal तक कितने वाले कोई बार जाना सही data रो mean median mode जितने वाले समान रही बे, सही data रे, हमें कोई बार सही distribution तक कोई बार normal distribution, जो के सिर्फ mean median mode समान रही बे नहीं, सही किस तरह को कोई बार माने ना स्क्यू तर माने के नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन का कहबा सिमेट्रिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन आउ ऑन माने स्क्यू डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन दा कहबा असिमेट्रिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन तर इन केस ऑफ नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन व्हिच इज कॉल्ड नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज कॉल्ड योर सिमेट्रिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सिमेट्रिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. And this in symmetric distribution, mean is equal to median is equal to mode only कोई पड़ेगा. तले in mean median mode तीन टांगा समान आपो यदि तीन टांगा समान आपो हमें यदि graph अरे नहीं दिखा graph और size का निश्चित रूप कोटे bell shape type रहा. इसी जे bell shape. Bell shape तरे ये middle रे तरे mean का जति की समान मीडियन भी सेती की सेतरे मोड ता माने जेड बोली कहली मोड एटा हला मोड एटा हला मीडियन एटा असला मीन ए तीनटा का समान एटा असला केस ऑफ योर व्हाट द सिमेट्रिक पार्ट. इन केस ऑफ असिमेट्रिक पार्ट असिमेट्रिक पार्ट का तो कहबा स्क्यू बोली को बंका टेढ़ा स्क्यू तले से स्कूम टा केमि दी ना सेटा बेल शेप हो बना সেই শেপরে কোণ হেলা গোটে তেড়া হয়ে যাইছে, এটা তেড়া হয়ে গেল, এইটা তেড়া হয়ে গেল, এইটা এমনি ঠিক রহিলা, এইটা তেড়া হয়ে যাইছে, নিয়ারা রহিলে এইটা তেড়া রহিলা, আউ বেল শেপ হেলানি। এটা হচ্ছে এই পার্টর, এটা যদি মোড ধরা গলা এটা মিডিয়াম, তারপরে মিন, এটা রাইট সাইড কি রহিলা, দ্যাট ইজ কল ইয়ার পজিটিভ স্কিউ। এই পার্টটা স্কিউ হয়ে গেল বঙ্কি, এটা কন্তি পজিটিভ স্কিউ। এই কেসের মিন মিডিয়ান মোড সমান রহিবানি, মিডিয়ামটা মিন অপেক্ষা বেশি হয়েছে, মিডিয়ান মিডিয়ানটা মিন অপেক্ষা বেশি হয়েছে। তারপরে আনাদার পার্টটা হচ্ছে যে নেগেটিভ স্কিউ, নেগেটিভটা এই তেড়াটা এই আর এইটা বেশি তেড়া হয়ে গেল, লেফট সাইড কটা, এটা মিডিল রহিলা, লেফট সাইডটা বেশি তেড়া, তাহলে দিস ইজ কল ইউর নেগেটিভ স্কিউ, নেগেটিভ স্কিউ। এন্ড নেগেটিভ স্কিউ দিস ইজ যদি মোড রহিলা, এটা আসিলা মিডিয়ান, এটা আসিলা মিন, ইয়ে বি সমান হেলা নাই, অলগ অলগ রহিলা। বর্তমানে এই যে টেঢ়া মেঢ়াটা হাইলা, এই পজিটিভ স্কিউ অর নেগেটিভ স্কিউ, তাকে আমি মেজরমেন্ট কেমিতি করিবা, তাহলে মেজরমেন্ট করিবা পাই দুইটা লোক আসিগলে, গোটে জন হইলে কালকিয়েশন, আউ জন রহিলে বাউলি, দুই জন রহিলে, তাহলে কালকিয়েশন বাউলি এ দুইটাঙ্কু কোন হেলা না মেজরমেন্ট স্কিউ মেজর কলে, জনে কম কলে না মিনি মোড আউ স্ট্যান্ডার্ড ডেভিয়েশন ର সাহায্য নেলা, আউ জনে কোয়ার্টাইল ডেভিয়েশন ର কোয়ার্টাইল ର সেমানে কোন কলে সাহারা নেলে, তখন বর্তমান মেজর অফ স্কিউনেট আসলা, মেজর অফ স্কিউনেস, মেজর অফ স্কিউনেস রে আমি জনক না দেবা কালপিয়ারসন স্কিউনেস, কালপিয়ারসন কালপিয়েশন কোএফিসিয়েন্ট অফ, কালপিয়েশন কোএফিসিয়েন্ট অফ স্কিউনেস, তাকো আমি শর্ট ফর্ম কইবা এসকে পি, এসকে পি মানে পিয়েশন কোএফিসিয়েন্ট অফ স্কিউনেস, এন্ড আনাদার আসিলা বাউলি কোএফিসিয়েন্ট অফ স্কিউনেস, বাউলি কোএফিসিয়েন্ট অফ skewness, এই বাউলি কোয়েফিসিয়েন্ট তো লিখিবা এস কে বি বলি কইবা, বাউলি বি বাউলি এস কে, এটা হলা পি হলা পিয়ারসন, তো এমান কো ভিতরে কেমিতি কোন বাহার কুচি না বাউলি কুচি যে কোয়েফিসিয়েন্ট অফ skewness টা হউচি এস কে বি টা হউচি না কিউ 3 প্লাস কিউ 1 মাইনাস 2 মিডিয়ান divided by u3 minus u1, তাহলে এই কেসে যে কোন সেই ইনফরমেশন দাও যে তোমার ডেসক্রিট দাও বা কন্টিনিউয়াস দাও গ্রুপ র কিংবা অন গ্রুপ রে ইন্ডিভিজুয়াল দাও তার u3 u1 আর মিডিয়ান বাহার করে দিলে এই ফর্মুলা পকে দিলে এসকে বিটা কোন হলা বাহি পড়িবো। আনাদার পার্টটা হচ্ছে কালকুলেশন, যেটা কি ভেরি ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট, ভেরি ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট ইউ রাইটিং কোশ্চিন বহুত সময় এই ক্যালকুলেশন উপরে আসুছে, তো ক্যালকুলেশন কোশ্চিন অফ স্কিউনেস টা কেমনি করছি না এস কে পি টা ইজ ইকুয়াল টু মিন মাইনাস অফ মোড ডিভাইডেড বাই স্ট্যান্ডার্ড ডেভিয়েশন, স্ট্যান্ডার্ড ডেভিয়েশন মিন মাইনাস অফ মোড ডিভাইডেড বাই স্ট্যান্ডার্ড ডেভিয়েশন, তাহলে এই ক্ষেত্রে আমি ফর্মুলা নেই পারিবা যে মিনটাকে আমি বার এক্স বলি কইবা মোডটাকে জেড বলি কই পারিবা স্ট্যান্ডার্ড ডেভিয়েশন তাহলে মিন, এই পরি ভাবে কোন হলা আমি বার করি পারিবা, তেনু স্ট্যান্ডার্ড ডেভিয়েশন তো বার করি জানছে, মিন বি বার করি জানছে, মোড বি বার করি জানছে, এটা বাহারি এটা পরে ফর্মুলা কো মনে রাখতে গেলে বাহির পড়িবা আমার, বাট দে ক্যালকুলেশন কোশ্চেন অফ স্কিমস ইট আনাদার ইনফরমেশন ইজ দেয়ার এ ইন দি কেস অফ রিলেশনশিপ, তাহলে ইন দি কেস অফ রিলেশনশিপ দ্যাট ইজ দি লাস্ট পার্ট অফ দি মাই টুডেস ডিসকাশন, দেন দি রিলেশনশিপ রে রিলেশনশিপ রিলেশনশিপ টা কেমতি কাহা সহিত রহিছি এ ভেরিয়েন্স রে সে কহুছি আমার P1 is equal to median minus a quartile deviation. This is one kind of relation. Then the Q1. And next one is Q3 that median plus a quartile deviation. And another relation, standard deviation is equal to 3/2 quartile deviation. And mean deviation is equal to 6/5 quartile deviation. So this is the set of relationship among your Q1, Q3, quartile deviation, mean deviation, as well as your standard deviation. These are all relating to your what? Related to measures of your skewness. Then under your measures of central tendency, measures of dispersion, and measures of variances, and measures of skewness, all four parts are there, will constitute your block two. And most of the questions, numerical questions, may be said on such information. That's all regarding. Another part is there. In the case of a continuous observation, very important is there. In the case of a continuous observation, sometimes the cumulative observations are there. You have to convert them into a normal distribution. That is the very important one. And say that the things are not possible, then our calculation things are very very many. तेणु बर्तन मुझे एक्जामपल खाली टी क्लीयर करने 5 minutes मोर टू योर टार्गेट पॉइंट से 5 minutes मोर भितर कौन है ना गोटे जिनस रही क्यूमुलेटिव फ्रीक्वेंसी कन्वर्टेड इंटु नॉर्मल फ्रीक्वेंसी कन्वर्टेड इंटु क्यूमुलेटिव फ्रीक्वेंसी नॉर्मल फ्रीक्वेंसी कन्वर्टेड इंटु क्यूमुलेटिव फ्रीक्वेंसी आम डाटा प्रोसेसिंग कही सारीसे बर्तन मुझे कहीदे अल्प टी मे बी ओपन एंडेड मे बी क्लोज एंडेड or maybe your cumulative form that is less than or more than form. So less than or more than concept on or maybe exhaustive form. So exhaustive means open end. Man open ta end hai nathibo. Complete end nathibo. We have to complete it. End part ta bhi end hai nathibo. Last group ta taku complete kara ji. So question hochi less than group ra sampad gota example do. Less than suppose less than suppose 0 and 10. Suppose the number of persons are there, that is called your frequencies are there. Number of 0 to 10, which is suppose you have any capital. Another part is less than 20, less than 30, less than 40, less than 50 suppose. Then 20 to which is suppose suppose. Less than 20. Then less than 17. Then 20. Then 30. These are the frequency 0 and less than 10. अरे जब यहाँ में बोलते scale नहीं जो आएगा scale का नहीं जो चाहे से scale अरे आरंभ है जी 0 रो तापरे 10 को लिए 30 से इनके नाके marking कर देना 10 को लिए किंतु 0 टू 10 भितरे 3 टा पिला अछंत एटा तुम काटि देले एडा कटि गेलो तनो 8 टा रु 3 टा कटि गेले 10 टो 20 भितरे केतिटा पिला अछंत 5 टा 8 टा माइनस 3 टा 5 टा तनो मु कहि तले एटी सिंपल एटा ए जो फ्रीक्वेंसी दिया जाय छी दिस कॉल योर क्यूमुलेटिव फ्रीक्वेंसी ए फ्रीक्वेंसी को हम क्यूमुलेटिव फ्रीक्वेंसी कहल किंतु ताको जनरल फ्रीक्वेंसी रे नबा पाई निहात दरकार वेरी इंपोर्टेंट रिमेंबर प्लीज ए एटा इंपोर्टेंट काहे कि पिलन को कोन करते है तो क्वेश्चन टर्न कर दिया जाए टर्न करले कोन हला इन क्यूमुलेटिव रे थिबे ताको जनरल रे फॉर्म को न ल पजंत कैलकुलेशन हे पाद न भूल होय छी तो वर्तमान कोन करी फास्ट ता क्यूमुलेटिव या जनरल फ्रीक्वेंसी से तापर सेकंड आसीओ केमती ना 8 माइनस ऑफ 3 दैट इज 5 थर्ड ता केमती आसीओ 17 माइनस 8 दैट इज 7 तापर 20 माइनस ऑफ 17 3 30 माइनस 20 दैट इज कॉल योर व्हाट 10 लेस देन 17 ले थी ले कैसे 17 ले रो और ना ये तो पहले ला इधर है ये तो पहले ही है हाँ ये तो 17 ना हमें 30 ले से 30 तो अब तो यही पोज़न तो 17 है ये 0 पोज़न तो 17 है तो ना हमारे दर क्या है हमारे 3 5 8 है गला भाई 8 रो 17 रो 8 गला ये तो 9 है 9 है 8 8 हो जाएंगे 9 है सी तापरे 40 तळु को रही थी 40 तळु को 8 रो लास्ट रे 0 पर्यंत केते 20 तनो 20 रो 7 गले 3 एटा 30 रो 20 गले 10 तनो एई रे आसीला हमर फ्रीक्वेंसी जनरल फ्रीक्वेंसी हम जतरा लेस देन थिबो किंबा मोर देन थिबो हमें सही अनुसार क्यूमुलेटिव टाको फ्रीक्वेंसी जनरल फ्रीक्वेंसी से कन्वर्ट कला करे देन जहां बाहर करिवार अछि करिवार either a mean in a median or a quartile or decile or percentile or a mean deviation or a mode or a median or a standard deviation or quartile deviation or a measure of skewness jaha bahar kare ra chi answer these are all relating to measures of your what the central tendency dispersion means variation and including mean deviation quartile deviation range standard deviation and your coefficient of coefficient of skewness of you got it
thank you sir and there is one question a student has asked that how to decide whether to opt for direct method or assumed mean method or step deviation method in a given data so by yes sir
another sensitivity in questions may not be asked to apply your direct method or your shortcut method or your step method step deviation method but you may apply any method is not mandatory to apply your direct method or shortcut method or your step deviation method any method you can apply tale it becomes easier to apply your direct method you apply direct method if you remember the formula or process of your application of your shortcut method apply shortcut method or apply your step deviation method step deviation method only can be applicable only when there is a common factor that is small I in the deviations yadi deviation mitre common factor nahi step deviation method apply hi karu kaam sarla बाकी वटन होला डायरेक्ट मेथड एंड शॉर्टकट मेथड आइदर डायरेक्ट मेथड और शॉर्टकट मेथड रे डायरेक्ट मेथड और शॉर्टकट मेथड रे जो मेथड अप्लाई करले चलिवो बाकी प्रोसेस ता मन रखले दरकार एंती तो कहुनी जे डायरेक्ट मेथड अप्लाई करो कि शॉर्टकट मेथड अप्लाई करो एंती क्वेश्चन रे काई ओकने यूनिवर्सिटी रे नाही किंतु हमें जेतले जनरल यूनिवर्सिटी रे क्वेश्चन उडा सेटिंग करू प्राय हमें स्पेसिफिक मेथड बेले बेले कहू अप्लाई शॉर्टकट मेथड तो फाइंड आउट मीडियन कि मामो तो से केस रे सेते बेले तामको डिटेल जानियो पडिबो दिटांग मेथड तीनटांग मेथड तीनटांग मेथड यदि जानिथिबा अधिकंतु दोसाबन नुआ त अप्लाई करले जोटा मेथड अप्लाई करले सेम आंसर बाहिरियो जोटा भलो लागछि अप्लाई करो किंतु हिंति स्पेसिफिक कि कहि नथिबो कोन यूनिवर्सिटी गुडा रे एही मेथड अप्लाई करबो
थैंक यू सर एंड एनी मोर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द लर्नर्स any more question thank you sir no more question is coming so thank you for nice session and for sharing and we have studied lot about descriptive statistics such as measure of central tendency and in this chapter we have studied arithmetic mean geometric mean and harmonic mean both in direct direct method sorry both in individual, both in individual observation, descriptive series, and class interval. And we have also studied geometric mean, harmonic mean, and we studied about measures of dispersion and phase variation, and where studied about range, coefficient of range, quartile deviation, mean deviation, standard deviation. Also, we have studied about measures of skewness. So, what is symmetricity of data? What is normal distribution? And so many things. So, thank you, sir. Very nice session, and this students must immensely be benefited from this session also. And this is an official announcement of closing of the session. And may I please request all the participants to be disconnected from the session. Thank you. Thank you all.
Hello, Kiro sir.
Amitabh,
sir, actually, it is a power cut here, so kindly upon recording, stop recording, sir.
Oh, okay.
Thank you.